CGTN, China Global Television Network.
Here you'll find caves housing over 50,000 Buddha statues, a treasure trove of sculptural art.
Here you'll find wonders of architecture that have survived for millennia, an ancient metropolis of the world, a meeting place of civilizations.
The architecture, statues, and city walls bear witness to history.
Where nomads and settlers met beneath the Great Wall of China.
Here, food allows us to bridge the past.
So we can experience the lifestyles of those who lived here a millennia ago.
This is Datong.
Chop chop, chop.
Let's get Foodwise.
Is it your first time here?
Yeah, my first time in Datong and definitely my first time here in Yungang Grottoes.
How do you feel?
I'm absolutely speechless. I mean, I read a lot about this. This is definitely on my bucket list.
Yeah.
Purely by hand, can you imagine?
Yeah.
And wow, the sheer size of it as well.
I mean, it was built around the same time as the Bamiyan Buddhas in Afghanistan, right? It's all Gandharan style.
Like the 5th century.
Yeah.
But I found a really popular dessert place and
okay.
I actually got in touch with her and she's actually going to be here waiting for us and maybe we can check out her shop as well.
Oh, this is incredible. Wow. It's like a watercolour palette, isn't it?
It is.
I didn't expect it to be so colourful.
And so detailed. Yeah. So many sculptures.
Oh.
Oh.
Hey, Na. Hello.
Pardon her.
我在云冈的莲花是非常特别的，每一个莲花的形状都不完全一样。真的是，
为什么画莲花不画这些菩萨？
我在这个研制这个北魏古法点心的过程中嘛，就是刚开始想要把它做成这个菩萨或者是佛像的形状，但是后来又想呢，这个如果把吃食做成菩萨，
不是不太合适。
你从哪儿开始吃？就是传奇里面讲的，就是太过于着相了，所以我就想到了见莲如见佛嘛，给了我一个灵感。
哎，你说的是甜点，什么甜点？
甜点我刚刚是有提到，就是北魏的点心嘛，它最具有代表性的就是羊羹，羊羹，但它不是羊肉做的，是一个非常精美的点心，也是云冈一尊石窟大佛的原型，最爱吃的。
那个大佛我们去看一下吗？好啊，就在前面。好好好，Should we go?
Sure, it's really good, like knowing all of the stories behind this, because otherwise you're just kind of gawking.
云冈的每一尊大佛的原型都是北魏的一位皇帝，这个就是第16窟的大佛拓跋浚，就是建造云冈石窟的那位皇帝，带着这个僧人昙曜建造的云冈石窟。
Wow, you can actually see his face through the window.
他是太武帝拓跋焘第18窟大佛的原型，边上那五个呢是他的弟子，和我们的这个西方人，就白种人的那面孔很像，就是从这个西域过来的。
It is a bit classical looking.
It is.
Yeah.
It's a bit different to kind of your everyday.
Yeah.
This place being like a melting point.
Yeah.
Melting pot of all the cultures there is.
Yeah, it's very international.
而且最重要的是，你们知道吗？就我刚刚提到的那款点心，它叫羊羹。就是因为他爱吃羊羹呢，就把一位会做羊羹的人叫毛修之封为了大将军。其实只会做甜点。是啊，对。那我们也能尝一尝吗？当然了。太好了，Let's go. I've been waiting for this moment.
The Emperor's cake. It's like a, whoops.
You're dropping all the ingredients.
There we go.
Wow.
Wow.
我现在眼睛已经在这儿了。我是从小就吃它长大的，因为我妈妈会做，然后家里面有传承。很多人都以为它是国外的，所以我就去日本考察。
然后发现在二十四史的宋书当中有原话记载，我的家乡大同当时的皇帝拓跋焘最爱吃的美食。
哇、wow.
在古时候它叫吊，
就一颗叫一吊，
然后它的标准是切六块。
啊啊，
这个还要分成六块？
对，一口就下去了。
那一人只能吃一块吗？
对啊，
你可以吃一吊，没关系。
I just have the whole 吊。
It's very delicate.
I'm gonna take this.
Excuse me? You still got three left.
它的口感是分层的。
Yeah, and it's not heavy either. It's very like
fresh,
bouncy.
当时可能只有北魏的皇帝才能吃得到羊羹。制作过程非常的辛苦，十八道工序大约72小时才能处12吊。让你们体验一下我的辛苦，尝试一下它中间一个碾的过程。
Okay, sure.
哦，让它变得很细，是吧
？It looks like chili con carne to me.
用掌心来碾压它。
OK。
要把这个沙摁下去，就是上面只留皮。
So, 用劲。Put some work in
mouth strap.
You're gonna like break the
mouth strap.
这块羊筋一定是很有力量的。
But I feel sorry for whoever's gonna buy this piece.
It's gonna be super smooth.
用搅拌机就搅搅很久很久很久很久，不是也是变成照样细了吗？
这是 sloppy，
很难吃。它是粗糙的一个口感，那这个你入口它是甚至也会有一点嚼劲，会有汁水从固体里面出来。那这个口感没有经过这么多的工序，它是出不来的。
那这个是什么东西啊？
这个就是我的发明专利糖茶，它在古时候这些甜点的统称是叫茶食。为什么呢？就是因为当时的茶太苦了，要配以甜点。
开始化了
啊！
茶还能解掉甜点的这个甜腻感。
It's almost like tea in the UK, right?
Yeah.
You have a dessert and then you.Team it and partner it with a tea.
Yeah, or like an espresso with a cake or something.
Hmm. But you think that people have time to do this? Drink a matcha, then eat a sweet, then feel.
我觉得现在的中国老百姓是已经从这个温饱到了更多的一个精神上的需求了，包括很多的游客听过我们介绍这个历史和文化的时候都是非常感兴趣的。
I'm gonna finish this because I know you've been eyeing this off.
It's fine, yours is melted. I'm gonna take that.
You make me work. You make me grind the chalk.
How else are you gonna learn?
But it's so good though.I just like, I might need to buy a box of this when I leave.
Beautiful wedding. Mm-hmm. What does it say? 道法自然。
道法自然，就是所有一切就是 like go with the flow basically of nature. Oh, because the Tao and Buddhism are all here.
There's so many different religions here.
That's right.
Well, there's actually two forks.
This looks too pretty for you. All right.I invited a photographer today because this is like a really famous temple here.
Okay.
It would be nice to get some professional photographers of us. So I hope you put on your best.
I only have one. It's always the best.
You look
born ready.
Incredible ready.
Do it, John.
Spectacular.
It is very
cold.
Oh, oh.
谢谢
谢谢贴心贴心。
这个上面有大同的。
Just in case we forget where we are.
Yeah.
接下来我们带你去一个有意思的地方吧。
还有更有意思的地方。
Sure. Let's do it.
Wow. When was the last time you went to church?
I think it was actually, it was St. Paul's in London.
Okay, so that's a proper church.
Yeah, I think it was under refurbishment, but it was in a better state of repair than this.
Yeah, and it was definitely in a lot more crowded area, I'm guessing. Yeah. This place is also a place where people are taking pictures, right? The shooting experience.
This is the Chinese Christian church's 7th sanctuary. Oh. It's from the Vatican. It's recorded.
Oh, is it?
那个是古代长城的遗址，是明代的吗？对，明代的。哪块是属于关外，哪块属于关内啊？长城的北面就是游牧民族。哦，我们这边属于农耕文明。哦，所以我们现在是在关内，对吧？所以农耕文明和游牧文明的交界处就在这里。
So it's where the north meets south.
And east and west too, right? With the,
yeah, with the church
here and everything.
In a very different setting.
It's definitely a lot more comfortable. Definitely
a lot
warmer.
But so this is something that they might have had back in the Northern Wei Dynasty.
I suppose so. I mean, like, that was 1500 years ago, right? Really hard to tell what the architecture would have looked
like. Dig it up and see what it looks like.
Yeah, but we are kind of surrounded by scenes of what it might have looked like back in the days.
Yeah, especially with kind of the nomadic tribes on their horsebacks.
Yeah, and it's even got the, what is it, the founding myth of the deer leading them to establish the capital here. It's so cool, though, because, like, they unified northern China, right, after a lot of fighting.
Yeah. So I'm guessing we're going to have food from that time?
Yeah, maybe. I wonder what the food's going to be like.
Oh.
这是我们餐前的锅铲。Oh, nice.
Appetizer.
Oh, this looks so similar to the kind of stuff I had in like in Mongolia and Tibet.
这个是当时游牧民族把这种我们塞外的一些饮食就带过来了，那么也可以加一勺的这个炒米。嗯。Mm.
Oh, that's so good. It tastes like one of those like sesame drinks or something.
Yeah, it's like a soupy broth type of thing.
Oh. Crikey.
Wow.
What is that even?
这也是当时游牧民族的一个粗犷的一个吃法，大块吃肉，就是它的原汁原味出来了，是这样的。这手把羊就是因为是这样吃的，是吧？
对，当时其实就是这样吃的，
对吧？大口吃肉。是。嗯，这个真的好香。嗯，它那个也没有羊的那个膻味儿。 这个道菜呢也可以尝一下，它在西方的话是很少有这种蒸的做法。蒸肉感觉就是会时间费很多时间吧？啊，是的，是的，它这个时间是需要4小时。嗯
，I think this is like it's very important. I think now we have that facility to have kind of meat.
Yeah, I guess, but also
you don't have 4 hours to be
exactly,
steaming.
Exactly, the cooking
beef.
Process is just—it just means that they were able to like stay in one place for longer periods of time in relative safety and like.
Exactly.
Have the wealth to be able to do that. I don't mind refined barbarian food.
You have to thank the times.
I'm still going to eat that with my hands, though. That's amazing.
那么我本身也是比较喜欢吃，也是比较喜欢这个行业，又是本土的大同人，翻了很多的一个书籍，包括《秦明要素》呀，包括南北朝的一些菜系呀，相当于考，还在考古是吧？考古<笑>
fusion as well.
And I mean, Chinese are very serious, even back in the days, about food.
Oh yeah.
And about people coming together to enjoy food.
It's a ritual event, isn't it?
It is.
This is our kitchen.
It looks very yummy.
Yeah. This 熟米是这道菜的灵魂之所。我们大同所有的人都在吃这个黄米，而且有这个熟米小王国之称。
这是什么？桂花吗？桂花汁，甜的。对，其实挺有意思的，因为一般都说就是北方比较粗糙。对，但是其实这个做的就是很精致了，你看有桂花在上面。哇，这会有牛奶香味儿啊，是吧？
Stuff in your face. After you just said that, people think that Northerners are very.
Some of them.
It's like barbarian.
It's like eating gelato with your hand. Oh, it's so good.
看见你那么亲我，特别高兴。
特别棒。
还是北方人的粗犷。
对。
Today. Actually, it's surprising because this is actually the second largest city in Shanxi province. Oh. Like, Datong's actually got more people living in it than Chicago.
Really?
This doesn't look like it. Right.
I was going to say too early.
Too cold, too early.
Yeah.
We should get some breakfast then while we're out.
Hangry?
And frozen ears? Uh-oh.
So do you know anywhere that's good? Anywhere
yeah, we should grab some noodles. The Daxiao Mian, it's the local thing.
Whoa. Oh,
this place is huge.
This looks like a legit place where we can have...
Man, it looks like they have a lot of choice for breakfast though.
So I'll have like every one of this to go.
你好，咱们这儿，我是龙翔的店长。哦，哎，你好，你好。咱们这儿早餐一般是吃什么呀？咱们老大同一般是以刀削面为主，咱们一步到这边可以看一下。这边就是咱们老大同刀削面一个制作现场
啊。This is the famous 刀削面。
对，
咱们的刀削面是用特制的一把钩刀啊，也叫钩刀面，最早那会儿，因为它那个面饼，包括整个后面那个板子，需要有一定的力量，因为重量很大。
嗯 ，I can make our noodles for us。你好，我来给您学习。哇，这么大一坨面，我的天，这得多重啊！
大概是一百的话是25斤，
25斤，
对，
我试试吧，就直接搭在这上面，哦，
对，
哦，还挺重的啊，
有点高，没事，
感觉自己都削，自己手指头都快削掉了。
Okay, I just saw Tianran skills, and I hope I don't get that bowl of noodles.叔叔您好 ，Hello，Hello。
我看这边也，我们这应该是个拼桌对吧？我们也有
那个小姐姐也是在这边吃，就是
可以早晨的时候看着古城的风景，然后吃一些早餐，感觉心情很舒畅。
那这一块的话，有什么？还有其他什么推荐的？
不要说，我最喜欢吃的就是羊杂鱼。我觉得就是来自各地的朋友都可以尝一尝，因为羊杂这个东西，只要他愿意吃，它是很好吃的，它没有怪的味道，只有香的味道，它是会有一点点辣的味道在里边，与其他地方的那种清汤是不同，是大同的特色。
太会推销了，我现在已经馋得不行了。
太好了
，Fantastic! Shanxi is famous for their vinegars as well.
Yeah.
Are you like shaking from holding the dough?
It was very heavy.
Oh, you're making me like so salivating.
That is delicious, especially when you make it yourself.
Right. It's all the hard work. I reckon I can do this. 3 meals a day.Maybe I can move here.
I'll get back into the kitchen then, shall I?
Well, that was a very satisfying bowl of noodles.
That's a great way to start today. Where do you want to go? What do you want to do now?
I've asked to meet my friend. He's like a foodie in the locals. So maybe she can show us around.
Oh,
I see Heidi.
Oh.
Hi. Hello.
来到大同，
谢谢。
我是大同当地的美食博主，大同美食饕餮娘。
对，哇，今天好漂亮啊！
穿的这是汉服。
汉服。
你要不要试一身？还好。
给他也来一身。
现在我们这边前头有一个那个大同的民俗表演，你们要看一下吧，体验一下大同当地的民俗。
哇，好热闹啊！感觉提前过年了。哇哦，舞龙啊 ，it's like a dragon dance。哇哦 ，Oh, you got this。
看到没？一个半立体，十个的管是个民族旗，左边单个是个大个旗，十个只剩有十个十。哎呦妈呀，这么帅！
谢谢啦，
谢谢。
I think.
I'm gonna go look around.
Oh, is this nice?
No, I have a friend too.
Are you tired now? Is this tiring out, Tianran?
No, I'm gonna let you girls have your girlfriend.
我觉得是，到时候再去盘，到时候再盘问他，我们也可以偷偷去点东西，是吧？
还有这种非遗的好工作的，
哇，
这
个
砖雕，
您这是用什么做的呀？
砖，
砖，然后就这么一点点刻的是吗？
你要这么
山西，山西是几个文化呢？哦、第一个是煤产业、嗯，第二个就是古建筑。啊、嗯，正因为山西有古建筑，延伸了我们这一批喜欢古建筑的人出来，在中国绝对没有第二家。
是不是雕的还很精？
太了不起了。
We'll let those two have their fun. I'm going to go find a craftsman who makes a very famous local product. Well, I hear the sound of hammering. 你好，师傅。你好，你好。
你好，你好。
哎，你好。我从外边就听到您在这个敲咱们这个锅呢。
提起来了。
那咱们这个铜锅您做了都有多久了呀？
我做了将近快40年了。
哇呵，对，这所以这是属于纯手工的。
对，这个手工做出来那个花纹清晰，嗯哼，这点做不了。
Yeah, it's true. It feels extremely. There's like this really good sort of texture here, and when you just pass your hands over it, even though I'm wearing gloves, it feels like it's very much 3D. 那咱们这些火锅都有什么讲究啊？
把炭起了火、拿筷子夹给
放在这里边，
这里边哎，
哦，这里边就跟炉子一样，反正有一个底儿、啊，然后就是咱们吃的都、哎、汤啊都放在这里，这一盖就可以煮，哎、是吧、哦？尤其咱们这种大冷天然后就是热腾腾的一个火锅，哦、那感觉太棒了，是吧？哦、
火锅热乎乎的。
您好，您好，
你好，尝尝我们家的黄花饼吧、
啊。好啊，
我觉得要吗？
嗯，是那种越嚼越香的感觉，
好鲜、嗯。它其实不光是咸，它虽然是一个咸的甜
咸口的，
稍微有点甜在里面也、嗯、
对。
然后看到。Hungry again after all that, to be honest. And I know they have like a local specialty called 凉粉。嗯，哦，really spicy looking. 对对，the really spicy looking soup.
是的，夏天都开车过来吃。
哇，就是从小吃的就是那个味道。他们说好吃，老板。哇，这。
你知道我们这儿的黄花还叫什么吗？嗯，叫做忘忧草，就是好像是古代会有治疗抑郁症的功效。
就一吃就啊，开心了，哎、
很开心，就是这样的。
忘记忧愁，
对，忘记忧愁。嗯、
哇，那我应该带点给天然尝尝。
啊，他抛弃咱们了，不给带，不给带。
Good stuff.
Time for cooking.
今天要给你们做咱们大同特别传统的什锦火锅。咱们今天要把这些食材就先用热水把它泡了。Okay. 我们大同菜系都是冬天比较容易储存的这个菜系列的。闻闻香不香
？Delicious.
绝了！会烫会烫会烫。
这是什么汤啊？是
这个是用一般的话会大骨头，就猪的大骨和那个鸡架熬的。
Okay.
我们等它开的功夫，我教你们做油面吧。
好啊、
大同特产的一款这个油面，
就那时候主要是用的杂粮是吧？
对，大米和白面我们其实吃的少，以前、主要还是以这种粗粮为主。
Like、
家里干过活，一看就是这样的。
是吧？
其实我们陕西跟山西都一样，从小到大要学会做面。像比如说搓成这种细细长长的、然后中间压一下，这个就是我们吃到的鱼鱼。像一条鱼似的、
啊、对，其实我们小的时候的确就是
家里头
偷玩
在做的时候，感觉好像是越活越回去，就小时候觉得这个味儿我吃不进去、但现在我反而闻的这个东西就很香。开动吧，吃火锅喽、
yes yes yes、
oh, we're just so okay、oh, the meat all right get you
这个也好了，
这个也好了，
下午咱们自己搓的油面、oh, wow. 这个油面的话可以蘸这个凉的这个料，给大家调了个凉料、
That's super addictive.
蘸上那个这个酱特别好吃。它正好就是又有这个下饭的这个味道，然后同时又有把这个面的这个味道又凸显出来。对，尝尝烧肉，
比较重，就是偏咸一点。
是的，因为我们最早之前要能做农务嘛，然后出汗量比较大，然后这边的话要吃的咸一点，然后去补充一下。
对。对。
你像我们这些谚语里头都有什么四十里的高，三十里的油面，就是意思你吃了油面，不走能走多远，多少里路这种的。
That's pretty cool.
因为你现在也在做美食博主对吧？最喜欢吃的一道菜是什么？
石井火锅
啊，就是这个，
非常的入梗，那种那个梗，入梗，
入梗，
对，入梗，
入梗，
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 什么意思啊？
他的那个意思就感觉你浑身就是暖暖和和、舒畅这种感觉，
从内而外开始把你自己的温度。
Are you rugged enough yet？
我现在非常的 rugged。
Are you rugged enough? I feel like I could be more rugged. Need to eat more for ruggedness.
对。
很多外地的朋友都说，哎，大同很多都是产煤的，然后我会告诉他，不，大同还有别的东西，就你可以来吃。就是我们北方人，大同人很豪迈，他的饭也不是说很豪迈，仔细品品，他又有一些细中又不太一样的点。
因为毕竟我们这边能够做种出来的农作物没有南方那么多，所以我们只能是在有限食材的前提之下去做，
就花心思。
That's what breeds creativity.
Exactly.
If you limit the amount of options, then that's how people are able to create all of these amazing dishes.
So what surprised you the most about Datong?
I think definitely how well they've kind of preserved the traditions.
Yeah.
Especially in its architecture as well, because when you have kind of a city revitalizing, they tend to go with like the modern stuff. But they've really kind of built on top of the old traditions, especially like the wall that we're currently walking on.
It's kind of wild when you think about it, because it was really at the fall of the Western Roman Empire
Correct, that
the Northern Wei, you know, unified Northern China.
So in a way, it's like the conquerors were won over by the settlers' way of life.
Yeah, totally.
By their culture and by their society.
It's very Chinese, it's very pragmatic. I mean, like the name Datong itself just means like everyone is equal, right?
Oh, that's true. So in a way, it's almost like no matter what kind of background, religion or culture you come from,We can always sit around a nice, good old hot pot and enjoy the meal.
Oh, I had no idea that you were going to say that. Wow, yeah, no, that's totally, that's how it is. That's the point
exactly.
of life. To share a good meal, hey?
Images may appear to be identical, but looks can be deceiving. The difference is not always obvious. It has to be discovered. There are always different sides to a story. We put the focus on the details. To see more, to understand better. CGTN. See the difference.